So now that we have created a new table, what we will do is we will try to insert some data into it. So first of all, if you click on hello, you will see that there is a statement which ran or which executed, which is select star from hello, which is the table name. So we can't see anything. Click on SQL and just type insert, which basically means insert some data into the table. So insert into table name, which is hello, values, bracket starts, and first is count, which accepts a numerical value or integer value. So we can type 1, comma, the second column's value, which can accept only characters. So we can have Google is awesome. So you need to include inverted comma and in the end, and bracket close and semicolon. So this is our statement for inserting a new row. So we are typing insert, which is used for inserting values into your table, and then into, we're telling that insert into the table, so the table name, and then what kind of values are they? So values followed by the values which are to be inserted into the table. So one is the first column and this is the second column. So you have to ensure that the sequence is correct or else it will show some error. So it always has to be in the same order. So now if you run this statement, you will see that it has successfully inserted some row. So if we'll select the so if we'll run this select star from hello, it will show us one row because we just inserted one row inside the table hello, which is inside the database being skilled. Now let's create or let's insert a new row into the table. So go to SQL again, and here we will type insert into table, which is hello, values, bracket starts, we can have 2, comma, inverted comma starts, and then let's say Tom, and then inverted comma close, and then bracket closes, and then semicolon. And if we'll run this, it will insert a row inside the table hello. So if we'll click on hello again, you will see that whenever we click on hello, it will run this SQL query select star from hello, which basically pulls out all the data from the hello table. So we will see that we have column 1, column 2, and 2 rows are there because we just inserted 2 rows inside the table hello. So this is how you insert data or rows into the table which you have in your MySQL database. Thanks a lot for watching our tutorial. In case you liked it, please leave a comment, and also don't forget to subscribe to our channel.